Live look at the river tonight, where a funding problem could cause some big problems for river traffic in the future. A lack of funding is preventing the Army Corps of Engineers from properly maintaining the mouth of the Mississippi River. WDSU reporter Simney Chuen breaks down how this is affecting river pilots and the Port of New Orleans. Simney?
Scott, it usually takes about $100 million to pay for the dredges or excavation that keep the river open and the river draft at a certain depth. But this year, the Army Corps of Engineers has slashed its budget to $63 million. And that means right now the channel into the Gulf of Mexico is not as wide or as deep as it should be. Ships like this one are a normal sight on any given day on the Mississippi River.
Last year we did over 5,000 ships coming into this river, the largest anywhere in the world.
But Gary LaGrange, president and CEO of the Port of New Orleans, fears big business on the import and export side could be lost if the Army Corps of Engineers isn't given enough money to maintain the river.
It's not only New Orleans, it's not only Louisiana, but the entire Mississippi River Valley and the Ohio River Valley. 33 states will be direly affected.
The federal mandate for the projected depth of the river is at 45 feet. It's usually drafted to 47 feet for safety, but the lack of funds has the depth at 44 feet.
If the ships have to start coming in light, with less cargo on board, that could threaten them, and it could threaten everybody in this area and in mid-America to possibly consider diverting to another port.
The width of the river has also narrowed from 750 feet to 400. That causes safety issues for river pilots like Captain Mike Larina.
This causes pilots to have to slow ships down, wait for other ships to pass the critical spots, and all of these things could lead to problems.
And LaGrange says that he is meeting with Congressman Cedric Richmond this Friday to discuss getting more funding for the Army Corps of Engineers. Scott?